The barn should be kind of like just off in that direction over the hill. And let's look around as we walk so I don't get jumped by a wolf. There's a rabbit. Ready for your favorite pastime. Okay, one more. All right, never mind. Miss and a miss. We might spend some time shooting at stuff once we get to Timberwolf Mountain just to have some fun. But I want to make some arrows first. Let's finish all of our crafting. Lower our carry load. I think actually this road that's snowed over here, I think if I just follow it, it should lead right to the barn, I think. I think I followed this thing away from the barn, and that's how we discovered those buildings over there. Yeah. Is that? No, that's a rock. But on the other side of it will be a barn, I think. Relatively certain. The birch forest would be over there. So there's stuff up there I've never been to, and Timberwolf Mountain is like often, might be like that guy right there, the big one. Timberwolf Mountain is one of these. And somewhere along there, most likely will be Skeeter's Ridge. The one location I've never been to, I don't think. Am I a regular follower of WWE? Not really. I watch wrestling very seldom. Like, occasionally, like, I'll watch a little bit, but no, I don't really follow it. I don't like being in this, in between these two snowdrifts. There could be wolves very close, and I would never know until we get attacked. What do I know about a game called Dwarf Fortress? What do I know about a game called Dwarf Fortress? I know you, I know Plump Helmets at Embark. How about that? Do they still consider that being in alpha? I think the whole alpha beta release nomenclature should mostly be abandoned at this point, because it, majority of the time it's used nowadays, it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't have any meaning. Okay, I see hay bales, so I guess we have to cross the bridge, huh? The nice weather confused you? Yeah. There's the barn. It's barely... My clothing is pretty nice, and it's, yeah. As I've said a bunch of times, the difficulty is easier on the challenges. I really hope they expand and add more challenges in the next update. Even if it's only like one or two. Because the challenges are pretty neat. Okay, I don't see anything. We've already looted all this. Pleasant Valley outbuilding. The traditional definitions for alpha and beta and release. Alpha is the part of game development when you're adding features to your game engine. When you have all of the features added, then you go into beta where you test everything and balance things, polish things, finish off like all the stuff, and then release is when you release it. but those terms don't really exist anymore. Not really. All right, so we're mostly going to be crafting. Looks like I left some wood here. And some food. And antiseptic. Oh, that's nice of me. Okay, sweet. Cedar firewood. So what I'm thinking is we're mostly going to be up there. But it's going to be for several days. I will need to make water. I guess we'll put the bedroll here. Oh, and a rifle cleaning kit. We can clean the rifle. Awesome. All right, let's do that now. Then I can drop that. A is for additions, B is for bugs. That's a pretty simple way to remember it. I mean, but when you're doing the early access thing and people are like playing your game for years, but you're continually updating the game forever, like the traditional definitions don't really mean anything if you're going to add things to the game forever. Like Minecraft is still adding features, so technically it's an alpha, like if you're going to be really finicky about the definitions. Yeah, let's sleep up there. I can always move it if we need to make water. I can probably make use of the soda for the next few days so I don't have to make water. Okay, be careful not to fall through the floor. Okay. I was stuck there for a second. Good. Okay, so we're at the barn. What am I doing here? My bars are full. We got 8 hours of daylight left. Do I need to drop it? I guess I don't need to drop anything. I'm not really moving. Let's finish the wolfskin coat. 15 hours remaining. Let's do like 5. We will get cut off when it gets dark. Okay, so 3 hours of daylight. Let's do 2 more hours. Let's do 2.5. Okay, lovely. Bearskin coat we're not making. We're going to make the bearskin bedroll. I do need more cloth. Yeah, we'll have to figure out how we're going to handle that. So I might have to make a run to get more cloth. There's no curtains here. I could run to the farmhouse to rip up some curtains. That's maybe the same distance either way. I'm not sure. Need to make a bow. At least one. Some arrow shafts. And then 8 arrows. Well, but now it's dark, so I guess we're going to bed. How excited am I for the nuclear power? The next update for Factorio is going to be pretty huge. They're adding the nuclear power, which I think is going to change the way that the steam engines work too. Last thing I read, the way I remember it, they're updating the way the science works, and they're adding fuel cargo wagons for oil and stuff like that. All that sounds cool. Gonna be pretty big deal. Okay. Can't craft in the darkness. Darkness. Okay, time to craft. Let's drink some water first. I will need to make some partway through, but let's finish up a couple things here. wolfskin coat. We will be wearing this to Timberwolf Mountain. Let's just finish. Bam.
I need anything right about now.
No, you're on a mission. A mission to craft a wolf coat. Badoosh. Done. Okay, nice. Crafted. 7.2 degrees protection, 7.2 degrees windshield protection, 60% waterproof, 15% stamina penalty, 15% armor. Pretty good. It's higher waterproof value than this. Although, see how broken these low difficulty items are? So it's not quite as waterproof, but it has better stats than the wolfskin coat. And it weighs half as much. It's ridiculous. Oh yeah, oh man. I like the style now. I'm starting to feel it. That really goes nicely with the mukluks. All right, we got 5 hours of daylight. Let's make a bow. Should have enough time for that. Unless it cuts us off at the end. We shouldn't lose the whole 5 hour progress, though. I think we'll just have to finish up the last bit, right? Did we finish? Crafted survival bow. Okay, so I've got two more of those. I'll probably make a second one. Because I wanted to use this challenge as an opportunity to practice the bow. So I'm going to craft a lot of arrows. Okay, it's dark again. Eat some food, go to bed. Okay, 249, let's eat that. -41 degrees of warmth. Yeah, it's pretty good. You can double up. I'm pretty sure you can just craft two wolfskin coats and like two deerskin pants and double up a lot of that stuff. But then you would have no sprint bar at all. I guess I could be using those to fill up my water bar as well. Thirsty bar. You should practice your sleep outside skills to prepare for the new areas. It's just, you mean it, while I'm in the barn, it's a bit too much of a hassle.
I'm gonna need to eat soon.
Okay. Can I craft yet? Maybe. Oh, that's right. Yeah, they were talking about updating the Factorio guys were talking about updating the combat stuff as well. They wanted to nerf turret creep. I think they've backed down. Like, their original ideas were a bit too crazy. Bearskin bedroll. I need six. Wait a second. I have enough cloth. Do I really not have enough cured guts? 2, 3, 4, 5. Seriously, buddy? Are you cereals right now? I don't have enough cured guts. Dang. If I make another bow, that will also take guts. Oh, okay, so we don't have enough. There is a workbench at the cabin. I guess I'm not making another bow now. We'll just make it there. So that means we need to kill some stuff before we can start working on that. I need to kill something outside. Those need to cure. I need so I can get some new guts. I guess we'll do the arrow shafts today. That's a bummer. 30 minutes each. Yeah, we can knock out all these. I miscalculated. I haven't been to a... I guess I was at a workbench in the mine. I could have checked and mathed it.
Where can I find
I just kind of thought, oh man, I got a ton of these guts on me. Surely I have enough, right? Turns out, nope, the bow takes 5. Which seems a bit excessive for one bow. 5 guts, 1 bow? It's not a compound bow. There's no way I need this many arrow shafts, by the way. But whatever. If it's worth doing, it's worth overdoing. Okay, that's all of those. Then we'll make some arrows. Simple arrow. I think you get your archery skill goes up when you just for making these. Yeah, so let's see what that increment is like. It might be different in different difficulty levels. Let's see if we can get to level 2. What's the bonuses for level 1? Nothing. Base, yeah. On Interloper, I wonder if it's a technique or like a strategy to try to make a bunch of arrows early on to level up your archery to make it easier to hunt with, because there's no rifles on Interloper. You want arrows to hunt with anyway, but it might be worthwhile to try to make as many as possible if you can get the feathers. Guts take 5 days. Requires light to craft. Okay, that increase was not massive. You would have to make a stupid amount of arrows to get a whole level. Maybe it's not worth it. Okay, it's dark again, so I guess we're gonna hunt something tomorrow to try to get some more guts while we wait for these to cure. We can make the last of our arrows. And I need to make water anyway. So we can spend a day doing that, like cooking the food we get and making new water. Calories. Don't need all of them. You misread that. You only need 2 guts for the bow. Oh, that makes more sense. I had 5. I needed 2. ? Hours of daylight left. The weather doesn't seem very nice. Hopefully it gets a little bit better. We can go do some hunting. If not, I guess we'll just do the firewood stuff or the water stuff. Let's look again. So I have 3 there on the ground. On me, I've got 5 and I need 6. Dang it. Let's craft the rest of the arrows. Then we'll go hunt. There were a lot of deer around. Last one. Sweet.
I could eat anything.
Arrow shaft, survival bow. Yeah, we'll make another one of these. I have like one with low durability and one that's full. I probably need to replace that if I really do a lot of hunting. But we can just do that up at the cabin in Timberwolf Mountain. One more stupid. Damn it. Don't think I really care about making any of this stuff. There is a, if I want to make a hook for fishing, there's a workbench up there. And, yeah. And, yeah. Why can't I move? Kind of stuck here. Okay, so let's drop some of the heavy stuff. I guess the ones that are cured, too. 2 cured maple saplings. Just Just put everything in a pile. Okay. Don't need all that food, all the clothing I'm wearing. Don't need all this stuff. That's fine. 84 pounds, still kind of heavy. Anything? Yeah, okay, that's good enough. So, 9 hours of daylight. Let's see if there's something nearby that we can murder. I also have a little bit of food down here, and there's already some firewood. Oh, and quality tools and lantern fuel. Left all kinds of stuff. Wow. There's a bear. Did we kill another bear? I don't think so. It's a bit too risky. Where can I kill him from that I would be kind of safe? Can I get on this thing? And he can't, maybe? Maybe we don't poke the bear this time. Let's look for some deer. -23 degrees. So if we just head back towards the rural store, which is down this road, there were a lot of deer over there. Shoot him and hop in a tractor. Yeah, I guess so. If you're in a tractor, it's not a loading screen, so that it is kind of a loading screen though. But the game doesn't reset. He keeps running around. If you go inside, sometimes their health respawns. I'm pretty sure. Had that happen a couple times. But a deer is safer anyway. Let's go kill a deer. See any. Could have sworn I saw a bunch right over here. And I don't see any. Maybe I traveled further than I recall. I guess they could have just migrated. It's been like 3 days. Groups of animals do tend to move around. They don't just hang out in one spot. Some rabbits. A rabbit's gonna have like, what, 2 guts on him? Is it worth killing a bunch of rabbits? I guess if I don't find any deer, maybe. I only need a couple more, really. I need a couple on me to use as bait. And then we'll need a few extra for a replacement bow, maybe? I might never even need that, though. You find the new UI is on Twitch is lagging the stream. Well, here's the rural store where we were. If I don't see any deer, I guess we're just gonna shoot some rabbits. Wanted to practice my archery anyway. If I get frustrated, we can just shoot it with a rifle. All right, rabbit time. I see no deer. I'm not confident enough in my bear hunting skills to risk the run on it at this point. I know I can survive an attack. I'm at 100% and I have a like 20% armor. I know I can survive an attack, but at this point I don't want to risk it on stupid things like that. Where'd the rabbit go? Let's try to sneak up on this one that's not sprinting. Okay, they both slowed down. I should just shoot it with my rifle. That would be faster. We've got 8 hours of daylight left. And a miss. Have I gotten better at shooting rabbits? Apparently not. My archery skill is level 1 as well, so there's an inherent inaccuracy. Your aim wanders, regardless of how good you are at moving your mouse around. Toenail Sin just subscribed. Thank you very much, Toenail Sin, for your subscription. Oh. Okay, rabbit. You are so skittish. I want to try to sneak up on them to get a decent shot, but we might have to just play the wait for them to sprint by me game. I've killed 2 rabbits before with arrows, and it's from that. Oh, come on! From waiting for them to sprint right by me. Stuck in a tree. Wonder if that does extra durability damage. Let's go over here where there's 2. Did I hit it? I don't see blood. Doesn't seem that way. I'll head back over there in a bit, see if it died, but I don't see any blood. Oh, bullseye! Oh, come on. 2 in a row would have been epic.
Something to eat.
I hit something from a distance. That's the first rabbit I've killed from a distance. Okay, sweet. Oh, 1 gut. Way to waste my time, game. One gut per rabbit. Sheesh. Oh, now the weather's going to go poopy. Hey, rabbit. If a blizzard hits, I don't got time for this. Another one over there. Oh! Second rabbit. Archery novice. Level 2. Wowie zowie. Okay. Bow sway reduced by 25%. Thank God. Arrow damage increased by 10%. The bow, it feels less awkward in my hands. That's what she said. Okay, I don't need the meat. Let's just... Their meat's not that great anyway. It only has 500 calories usually. Just get the guts. Oh! Okay, another level up. Carcass harvesting level 3. Reduction in harvesting time. Can harvest 50% frozen carcasses by hand. Just like this motion. Reduction in hide or gut harvesting times. Well, that's good because that's what I'm harvesting right now. Guts. No hide for men's. I made them a long time ago, and they're just not as... They're too heavy for the stats. Basically. It's not easy. There's no reticule. Like, when you zoom in, you can't just put this little dot in the middle of my screen. You can't just put the dot on the rabbit. Plus, there's actual arc, too. It's tricky. Oh, he was coming this way for a second. Did I retrieve a... I didn't ever count how many arrows I actually have. We should try not to lose any. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Got 11. Bow is an extension of my arm. Come on, rabbit. Seventy-nine, ten, 11. Oh, that was so close. Oh, now he's running. Dang it. Technically, I did get enough for what we need right now. Don't really need the food. I have the... We have to wait for the ones to cure. I needed a few for... just as bait, basically. Come on, rabbit. Why are you so elusive, rabbit? Pull the thing. Dang it. Oh, that one might have nicked him. Okay, the weather's getting bad. We should just head back. The weather can get really bad in this place. And then you can't see a thing. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I'll harvest that later. Yeah, let's get out of here. Hopefully I can find that road. Didn't bring a bedroll with me. Should be over in this direction-ish. Where is the road? Is this the road? That's the road. Okay. I think this way. We'll figure it out one way or the other. As long as I found the road, we'll be okay. I might be going in the wrong direction, but that's okay because I have this thing that I can just follow. We can turn around if I realize I went the wrong direction. As long as we don't get jumped by a bear. Yeah, this blizzard in this zone has... Yeah, okay, I went the wrong way. No, we do need to cross the bridge, right? We need to cross the bridge to get back. Because I think I crossed it to leave. But either way, we can still just keep following. I've lost a... What, like two or three different sandbox characters to this exact scenario? There's the building. Okay. See, no big deal. Alright, so we've got question mark hours of daylight. I think it's probably like 6 or 5. How much firewood do we have? How wet am I? Whoa, I'm wet! Let's go ahead and take those off. Although I don't think I need to worry about that if I'm warm. I think being wet is okay as long as I'm not freezing. I think you get hypothermia from being cold and wet. Got some food. I am 77 pounds, so may as well pick that up. Don't think I care about the antiseptic. Alright, how much of this do we have? Decent amount.
All this gear is slowing me down.
Don't need the newspapers, though. Don't have any sticks. Is there a book on the ground? Can we go find some sticks? Scrap metal. Could make hooks out of those. Sticks. Let's go see if we can score some sticks. Some trees over here. Just watch out for the bear. I don't think I ever noticed that the trees wave back and forth in the wind. Look at that. Pretty nice. Pretty cool. Got any sticks for me, tree? How are there no sticks on the ground? Did they not spawn until the storm is over? A little bit cold. Oh, I took my clothing off. That's right. I forgot. I went outside almost naked.
I can barely walk with this much gear.
I really only need one to get it started. May as well grab several. So, we should be able to make... I don't need to cook anything, really. Well, I guess I'll cook the rabbit I scooped up out of the carcass. The meat bag. Mostly, I just want to make water. Should be able to make enough to, well, I say enough to finish the crafting, but we still have to wait for the stupid thing to cure. Okay, and just leave all this on. Question mark, hours of daylight.
Well, I
Oh, it didn't work. Okay, that's why you get more than one stick. Oh, I suppose I should be doing this, huh? This is the habit we should be in. Use one match for multiple attempts. Okay, looks successful. Just going by the visuals.
Well, that didn't work.
Maybe not.
Come on. Come on.
Come on. Need to get my skill up. I'm not sure exactly. I assume you get skill ups from failing. Starting a fire, but I've never actually checked. Maybe it's only for successful fire starts. Need to get the skill up anyway. It's pretty low. I have accelerant? Yes, I do have accelerant, but I
did it.
I try to save it for when I'm outside and I need it right then. I'm inside, so I've got tons of matches. I don't care about doing multiple attempts. So I just save that for when I really need it. All right, 5 hours. Let's cook up. Oh, you know what we can do? Do you know what we can do? I may have left it upstairs. We'll have to go retrieve it. You always wonder how they boil water in fire barrels. Yeah, there's some, I can make more tea. We should also do that. Stream is buffering like crazy. Twitch just updated their UI. I don't know why that would be related, but maybe it is. You know what I'm in the mood for? Some 40% banged up pinnacle peaches. It's been a while since I've had some pinnacle peaches. Okay, here we go. We're in a barn. We have a fire in a barrel. There's a blizzard outside. We're wet and cold and starving, and we are cooking up some pinnacle peaches. Oh! We need a pinnacle peaches emote. One day we'll have a pinnacle peaches emote. Okay, fantastic. So before I make water, actually let's make water now, because I'll need it to cook up the tea and stuff. I'll just do a gallon right now and see how much tea we can make with that. Sounds like the weather is clearing up a bit. Question mark hours of daylight. Oh, I have an.
This
I already.
Bag is getting too heavy to carry.
Did I not eat them? I didn't actually. I didn't actually eat the banged up pinnacle peaches. I heated them up and then I forgot about them and they got cold. So let's heat them up again. Okay, moment slightly ruined. All right, now we'll eat them. Mmm. Oh, it's delicious. Okay. What was I doing? We've got 2 hours of wood fire time left. Yeah, let's cook up some coffee. That cooking skill up, though. All right. That is... Yeah. Making sure I'm not just heating up old cups of coffee. Instead, we're brewing up new cups of coffee. Pork and beans got dusty. That just adds flavor, really. Less than an hour of daylight. Okay, that's pretty good. Timed that fairly well, even through the I didn't know exactly how much time was left. I just kind of guessed, and it lined up pretty well. Didn't waste all of my firewood. A lot of tea. Cook. So at about 20 minutes, we'll take the brand and go upstairs and sleep. Looks like that's all of my... Okay. I wonder how much actual water I have left after making all this water-based food products. Cup. No tin. Okay, that's all of it. You have 3 reclaimed wood left. We can go get more stuff outside. That's not a problem. We're waiting for stuff to cure anyway. Yeah, all right. Oh, cooking, level 3. Do I need to leave anything here? This? I'm low on tinder plugs, but we can make more of that, no problem. There's a bunch of newspapers I dropped, which we can break down for that. So, cooking level 3. 15% calories from cooked food, based on what it already had. And no calorie loss when smashing open cans, which I don't care about because I've got a can opener. Cooking time is reduced by 10% is nice when you're cooking a bunch of stuff in bulk, I guess. The main benefit there is the bonus calories. Still have a bunch of crap sitting there as well. Okay, so these are at 43. They're going to take, like, another 2 full days. So let's eat just a little bit of food and go to bed. What's low? Actually, one of these is going to be, like, 155. That works out pretty well. Yeah. Just dump that on my bedroll to warm up my sleeping bag a little bit. It's like putting a hot stone under the covers. Nature's something. Fire hazard, I don't know. Okay, 53 days. Question mark hours of whatever. Darkness. Hopefully the weather's not bad and we can go get some wood to make some more water. Need to wait a few more days for the daylight. 53%. Let's drop some of this stuff. Keep that on me. 80 pounds is fine. Let's harvest that so we get more feathers back. I've been waiting for it to break. Why doesn't it use the bow that's lower durability first? It's using my high durability one, which is already to 40%. Okay, we are gonna need that replacement bow before too long. Or we just forget about the whole bow and arrow thing and just use my gun. Or just not get into fights. 4 feathers. Okay, so we can make a replacement arrow.
Never thought I'd be dying from starvation.
I did shoot arrows for a full day. That's true. You have a point. I will concede the point. Okay, so I've got some torches. The weather outside is dreadful. Oh, I put my clothing back on, I guess. Well, that's better. I feel much warmer already. If the weather's bad, what do we do to pass the time? We've got cured bear skins waiting to be made into a super fancy bedroll for Timberwolf Mountain. I maple saplings. We need guts to do something with those, and those are reserved for the bedroll. Maybe it's not as bad as it sounds. We can go look. Maybe it's not that bad. Make boots with the fur. You need deer hide for boots. Let me put this over here by the fire thing. I'm probably going to forget that this stuff is here. I don't need the tools. Quality tools are for repairing hacksaws, maybe? I think you can repair lanterns with just basic tools. Oh, it's not bad. Okay. Well, we gotta wait like 2 days just for that stupid stuff to cure. So, I guess we can do a bit of scouting. Well, there's the bear. So, the barn, not the barn, that's the barn. The farmhouse is over there. The cave, not the cave, but the mine. It's a cave, but it's also a mine that leads to Coastal Highway is off in that direction, as well as the, there's a deer, as well as the, rural store is over there. So to get to Timberwolf Mountain, it's going to be off in that direction. I want to scout that, but now I see these deer. So I want to go hunt a deer to get some more stuff. Shoot the bear with the bow? It sounds like a bad idea. This doesn't look like a good area to hunt a bear from. I guess you can jump in the, oh, there's some sticks and stuff. I guess you could jump in the... What's the word? My brain is not working today. Tractor. Which one's closer, this one? They're about the same, huh? Okay, he's moving, and we'll go for this one. Stop moving. Or walk towards me, one or the other. You maintain that a 303 Brit from even a SMLE. You're using way too much jargon. I don't know what you're talking about. I know what you're saying. It takes more bullets because of game balance. All right, that's close enough. Oh, right in your butt. Okay, let's shoot at this one now. That bear's not sneaking up on us, is he? He's way over there. That other one's like, Harold, what's the problem, Harold? Harold, you have an arrow in your backside. Little does he know, he's about to have an arrow in his backside. Stop walking. Stop walking. Okay. Sorry, Fred. You died before Harold. There should be another arrow over here. Yeah. All right, let's scoop out Fred's guts, and then we'll go check on Harold. What's my arrow durability looking like? They're doing fine. My bows are getting low. Yeah, a deer. Much easier to kill than a rabbit. Who would have thought? How warm is it? It's 30 degrees. Yeah, okay. Let's drink some water first, though. he sounded like a deflating animal balloon. Only two guts. It's a bit disappointing. I guess the bears have 10, huh? Maybe it would have been worth it to fight the bear. I don't want the hide. I might come back for the meat. Let's go check on the other deer, see if we can track him down. Let's check our bow skills as well. Oh, okay. You want some of this? Oops. I wonder if that guy plopped over somewhere, because I don't see him. Did we loot this? Do I have my crowbar? I have looted it. I don't know where that guy went to. He might have ran over there. Or he's over there. They usually don't just run in one direction. They usually kind of run back and forth when they're hurt. I don't see any deer. All right, let's check on the other side of these rocks. How many zones do I have left? Two. But we're trying to craft the bearskin bedroll before I head into the next spot. And we're waiting for some entrails to cure in the barn over yonder before we craft it. He must have run over here, right? Is there another explanation? He up and disappeared on us. I guess it's possible he just flat out despawned. Like the game glitched or something. Oh well. If he's around, I don't know where he is. Have you got the plant achievement? Yeah, I got that a little bit earlier. All right, I guess we can grab the sticks. I'm gonna be cooking up some meat and making more water. So we should start collecting firewood as we see it. If I see a log on the ground, we'll chop it up. Speaking of which, do I see any logs on the ground? 7 hours of daylight, there's one. Yeah, let's chop this. It's not freezing, or it's at freezing. Do the deer leave a blood trail? They should, but I didn't see one. Because I shot at the other one. Okay. We should be able to cook up quite a bit just from that. We can go back and see if there's a blood trail. With the snow blowing, it's possible the tracks are already gone. When he ran off, it looked like he ran off towards the hay bales. When I shot him, he was like right in this patch of grass here, somewhere around here. And I see no blood. Oh well, I wanted the extra guts, but it's okay. There's tons of meat on this guy, more than I'm gonna need. 26 degrees, I think we can still make use of that. So let's do like an hour's worth. Yeah, no big deal.
This gear is starting to slow me down.
Okay, level up. Wolf in the background? I didn't see any. Where did you see a wolf? That's a rabbit, friend, if that's what you saw. Okay, let's go back to the barn. Oh, there's a wolf. I see one now. He was directly in our path, too. You are yelping. What are you running from? Did you get in a fight with a bear? What happened? Have some deer meat. There's some guts. Give me those guts. Maybe he got scared of my coat. Oh, yeah. I remember reading about that, that the wolfskin coat was supposed to scare wolves. He might have been chasing a rabbit, but he made the dog yelping sound like he got hurt. Or at least that he was scared of something. Huh, I wonder if it was the coat. I've read that the coat can work as long as they can't directly see you. Like, they can just smell another wolf or something, they'll run away. The bearskin coat scares them. Oh, not the wolfskin coat? Oh. So much for that theory, then. I don't know exactly what it was. Okay, so first off, let's go place some stuff on the ground up here. Wolfskin works too. Bearskin's better. It's going to take a long time to really know these kind of things for sure. It's hard to test these things very often. Okay, 60%. We only need one of those to cure. And I only need like two on the ground at a time. Or two to use as bait. So we'll have four more curing. A lot of meat. Go make a fire. Yeah, let's break down one of those. Running low on the plugs. Three left. Am I wearing the wolfskin coat? Yeah, it's pretty good. It's got decent stats. It's got really good stats. It's just heavy. It's pretty darn heavy. Okay. Hang on. Let's do the proper technique here. Light the torch. Then light the fire. Oh, I can't see what time it is while we're starting the fire.
That didn't work. Come on.
Come on. Next time I start a sandbox character, I'm going to pick the female just to get a different series of voice cues. I've heard a few of her clips, and I couldn't tell who it was. Like, it sounded like a super familiar person. Like, I've heard this character, this person, in, like, a movie or a game or something before. And I looked her up. Let's see, 3 hours of daylight. And turns out she's the most prolific female voice actor of all time. So she's been in, like, everything. If you look up her... her Wikipedia or her IMDb, the list is just ridiculously long of all the projects she's been involved in. So that didn't help. I have no idea where I recognize her voice from. Because I couldn't figure out what on the list I was trying to think of. Okay, what are we doing here? We are gonna cook some meat. Okay. What's my fire skill at? 2 or 3? If it's 2, it's close to 3, something like that. Cookie, cookie, cookie. Jennifer Hale. Yeah, there you go. She, yeah, she's been in a lot of stuff. She had like a few characters in Baldur's Gate. She was the female character in Mass Effect. She's been in all kinds of cartoons and other voiceover projects. Just like a ridiculous list of different projects she's been in. 1 hour and 4. I guess I don't need water right now. We'll just finish cooking. Cookie, cookie, cookie. Do I have raw meat upstairs? I don't think so. I think I ate it all, except for the rabbit that I have on me. So I think what I want to do, let's extend this fire a bit. Finish up the meat and drop that outside. Because we are going to be here a few more days even. May as well. Not that big a deal, right? Okay, 37 minutes. All right, it's windy. This is not when you want to be outside. Eat that tonight. So let's drop firewood on the ground again. I didn't make any extra water. We can do that tomorrow. We still have to wait on the guts. And then after the guts, we'll have to be making the bearskin bedroll. It's gonna take a while. Let's look in the workbench, see how many hours that requires. I think it's gonna be like 25. I think. Something like that, something stupid. So, let's see. Bear skin bedroll 17.5. Okay, so that's better than I thought. This is what I guess I was thinking of. The bear skin coat takes 30 hours. 17.5, we can do that though. All right, so what are we having for dinner tonight? We're gonna have a little bit of freshly grilled rabbit, freshly as in like 2 days ago, and a candy bar. It says it's an energy bar on the wrapper, but you know what it really is. It's a candy bar. Okay. 2 hours of darkness. I think I've got one more day to wait for the guts. That's so annoying I mistimed that. 72%. It was at 49%, so it did 23. Yeah, it's going to be about a day or slightly more than a full day. So what we should do is go try to find some wood and make some water. But definitely don't have enough for that entire time. Hopefully it's not... if it's cold, it's fine. I just hope the visibility is okay. Weight is at 74. I guess that's okay. Is my clothing doing all right? Pretty good. That's still at 100. That's nice. Okay. And we need to make some torches. Unless I might have dropped some up there. There might be extra torches. All right. So, come on. Up here we've got one, two. Okay, I'm having some difficulties. Three. My stomach's growling just looking at all this cooked meat. 11. No, 9. Okay, so let's head over to these trees. There's probably going to be some down, some tree limbs and stuff we can chop up. There's one. Look at this guy. This is going to be like 4 pieces. 5. Oh, I feel heavy. I feel much slower all of a sudden. I think if we get just like one more, that should be enough to cook for like, to make a fire for like 8 hours. Typically one of those logs will last like an hour and change. How heavy am I? I'm only 80 pounds. I must be, I'm walking into the wind or something because I'm moving super slow. Yeah, the wind is in my face. A deer. All right, we've murdered enough deer. Let's leave him alone. Don't need to kill more deer just yet. 3 more is enough. Am I gonna kill the bear in this area? I don't plan to. I've killed 2 bears, and we're about to craft the bedroll. There's no reason for me to kill the bear at this point. It's too big of a risk, I think. Unless I really just, the mood strikes me, and it might, and I decide to risk it all. Yeah, I know a lot of people associate her voice as the female shepherd, but I never played as the female shepherd in Mass Effect. So I don't think of Shepherd as using her voice. So I don't think it was that. It was something she was in. But it could have been any of a number of things, who knows. Yeah, best defense, no be there. We don't really even need the bearskin bedroll. I mean, I'm only doing this just because I've never made it. And I want to use it and see what it's like. There is a bed at that cabin as long as we can get there. I might not be able to get there. We might have to sleep in a cave. I don't know. So having a bedroll of some sort is okay, but I've already got one. Just kind of doing it just to do it. Okay. Should be some sticks in here too. Can the ecosystem actually provide for? I've never seen more than one bear at a time. I guess it's possible that there would be more than one. Will you sleep in the bearskin bedroll like a tauntaun? I guess so. You're baffled that their small dev studio got those two guys to those two people for their small game? I'm not really surprised after looking at her resume with the amount of work she does. She just seems like a
damn it.
Will do anything, anywhere, anytime, workhorse kind of person. This torch is about to burn out. I'm not really feeling the visual. Oh, here we go.
Nope. Why didn't that work?
The torch went out. All right, let's just use matches. I only have one torch left right now. I will craft some in a bit. But I've got a stupid amount of matches. How's the Nomad coming along? Two areas left after we finish up in the barn. Come on. There we go. Matches all the way.
Turned out pretty well.
Okay, 10 hours of daylight. Let's just load it up. Noise. 8 hours should be good. Let's make this. I should still have enough cloth to make the bedroll. If not, we'll have to figure something out on the next day. All right, what are we going to do, make water? We've already made a bunch of food. Let's make like 4 gallons.
Die if I don't get some food soon.
I'm pretty sure you won't. You're at 99%.
Load for much longer.
Pineapple on the pizza. Oh, wow. I don't know why you're talking about pizza, but I suddenly want a pizza now with pineapple on it. I do not think it's available in the Canadian apocalypse, though. Unfortunately. We're gonna have to settle for pinnacle peaches. Okay, I need to extend you a little bit. Don't go out, don't go out. Don't go out, don't go out. Okay, 8 minutes.
I need to find a place to rest.
All my food's up there. Let's actually move it up there. 2 hours of daylight, yeah. We're done with the fire. Let's just take the brand. Look at all those matches. I might even just leave some matches here. I don't need all those matches. Peaches on a pizza. I don't think that would work very well. There's way too much moisture in a peach, and then when you cook it, it's all going to come out. You're going to be making some soggy pizza. Don't think that's going to work, unless you dry them partially beforehand. Seems kind of complicated. You can just save the peaches for dessert. You don't need them on your pizza. All right, so all of our piles of stuff. Put all the water right here. I wonder, the piles of stuff, like when you drop stuff, it just kind of spreads out. I wonder if you're standing right next to a ledge, if some of it will be down below you. Okay, hurry up. Yeah, we need some food. Oh, I left it out. Crap. Damn. see the extra torch? Was there one up there? I wasn't looking for that. Oh, I know I saw this somewhere. That's burnt out. My fire stick's gonna burn out. Does 20% one day. Oh, it didn't burn out. Yeah, okay, there it is. I see it now. All right, so freshly cooked venison, actually freshly cooked, 100%. Yum, yum. No. Drop your, yeah, there you go. Okay, 1 hour daylight, 10 hours of darkness. Okay, 2 hours of darkness. So I think we have to wait kind of till the middle of the day to start working on our bedroll. Yeah, 91%. I think we're just going to play some solitaire to get there. The meat outside of the door thing, yeah, that does not attract animals. I haven't heard anything from them. From the developers saying they are going to change that. 10 hours of daylight. Ravenous and parched. And winded, although I've only been sitting still all day. 97. This is my longest run. Oh yeah, I guess technically it is. Actually, it's not. It's the longest run I've streamed. I have my second ever sandbox character is still alive. And I play that character occasionally, like at night when I'm kind of tired and I'm just winding down for the day. That guy's still alive. He's at, like, day 100. There we go. Finally. Okay. Here we go. Good. Hopefully I have enough cloth now after I made those torches. I do. Okay, we've got question mark hours of daylight. I don't like how you get stuck right there. Let's do, like, 3 hours. See if we get an update on the darkness. Okay, now it's dark. I don't have any food here. I guess I'll just eat normal stuff, like some dusty dog food. The meat outside, it's cold. It's a natural refrigeration. Okay. Mostly to avoid the smell. No, I'd rather have the smell of cooked meat indoors. I'm craving like barbecue and pizza now. I must be hungry. Craving all these foods. 2 hours of darkness. True for all foods or just meat? Just meat. The like the canned foods and the wrappered, anything like man-made in a package lasts longer inside, I'm pretty sure. Some of them it doesn't matter.
I
could eat. I think mostly right, it's better inside. Okay. So, hunting knife. My durability on my tools is actually, I'm down to 72%. Need to keep an eye on that. Let's do 6 hours. So we'll finish this tomorrow. And then maybe we'll move out. It depends on how much of the day is left. And I should go downstairs to get some dinner before it gets while it's daylight out. 6.7 hours for, yeah, we'll have like 9 or so hours of the day left. Let's go get some dinner. Got lots of stuff to carry too. And I can't take all this with me. Okay, long load times. So we got 4 hours of daylight left. I'll do like 3 hours and then we're gonna get stopped because of time, because of darkness. Let's do 3.5. I suppose I could like set up a, do I have a lantern available? I don't think I do anymore. I broke it down, didn't I? Okay, we've only got 3 hours left. If we start right when the sun comes up, we should still have, like, as long as the weather's good. If there's a blizzard, we're going to hang out here, obviously. Okay. If it lets us do it, let's do it. I think it's going to stop us. Yeah. Okay, where's my bedroll? Bedroll. It's very dark. There's a workbench. Okay, there's the bedroll. Calories. You woke up fully rested, 2 hours of darkness. We want to be as rested as possible for when we leave, so let's do 1 hour of solitaire and 1 hour of
need to eat soon.
Sleepy, never mind. There. Okay. Let's have some water. Okay, then we'll finish this guy up. 2.53 hours. Question mark hours of daylight. Hopefully the visibility clears up because I don't really know where we're going. Crafted bear skin bed roll. Bam. New item. Bear skin bed roll, 6.6 pounds. Crafted from the skin of a bear. So you notice when you sleep in this thing, it tells you the warmth bonus is 6.4 degrees Fahrenheit. It's like 3 degrees Celsius. Wow. That's way better. 21.6. Burns the same amount of calories. Wow. That's a big leap. I was expecting double, not triple. Well, all right. Pick it up. How heavy are they? Oh, no, no, stop. Oh, I didn't mean. I'm hitting escape. What are you doing? I meant to pick you up. How long did I sleep for? Hopefully, just 1 hour, right? Yeah. 2.2 pounds, 6.6 pounds.
So hungry.
But we're going up to the super cold place, so let's bring the nice one. All right, those are burnt out brands. I'll take the cured guts. I need one of those for a new bow. I'm not taking both of them. And then we've got to sort through all this stuff. Let's pick everything up and then drop stuff we don't want. That'll be simpler.
That feels like a lot of gear.
'Cause it's all stacked on top of each other. My weight is at like 100. Pick up everything but the water. We might be here, and I also have the meat outside. I'm not bringing the rifle cleaning kit, so let's clean that one last time and drop the cleaning kit. The weather outside, we can't travel in that weather, so we may as well spend some time sorting through the stuff we want to bring. I definitely want a crowbar. What I need is a saw to open the containers in Timberwolf Mountain. I have not found one, I don't think. Or I found one a long time ago and I left it. Actually, I think I left it at the radio control hut in... It's not that far from here, but we're not going to get that. I don't care that much. Don't need three of these. We've got five torches, so let's leave this behind. Don't need all these flares. Four is more than enough. Drop those. I want to bring that. Five cloth and three cured leather seems like a good idea to repair my clothing. That's a lot of coffee. Okay, let's just eat one of these. The percentage is getting low. Down to 98 pounds. I haven't picked up any of the water yet, is the thing. I guess we don't need to... We have to spend 3 days at Skeeter's Ridge so we can make more water there. I don't need to bring a ton. Mostly want to bring food. Okay, so 1.3 gallons. Let's just pick up a few. Go check out the weather. I think it's going to be pretty bad, probably for a few hours. I'm willing to leave and explore as long as we have like 8 hours of daylight left. Doesn't the bearskin bedroll scare away wolves? I think I remember reading that, but I don't know how that works. Like, it has to be on the ground, or it only works while you're sleeping in it. Yeah, we're clearly not traveling in this weather. Not gonna happen. Skeeter's Ridge is in Pleasant Valley. You can tell because the areas are organized by location. So Skeeter's Ridge is here, and it's in between the barn, the radio control hut, and the rural store, all of which are in Pleasant Valley.